Global Power Technologies. Power where you need it.
Hi, I'm Darcy with Global Power Technologies, and today we'll be discussing the installation and operation of an 8550 TEG. When you first get your TEG installed on location, there'll be a few things inside the cabinet that you'll need to install first. We'll start by using a 9/16 wrench to install the fuel line. So you want to insert it into the bottom of the T-fitting, get it hand tight, and then snug it up with the wrench. And then using a half inch and a 9/16 wrench, you're going to insert the other end into the fitting on the bottom of the Venturi, hand tight, and then snug it up. Next, we'll install the shutdown relay assembly. All right, so we'll begin by using a 3/8 wrench and install the male end of the relay assembly into the bottom of the shutoff valve. You'll take the threaded coupling and hand tighten. Be very sure not to over tighten this fitting, just get it nice and snug. Then we'll take the thermocouple and put it into the other end of the relay assembly. Then using a 3/8 wrench again, tighten the fitting into the bottom of the assembly. Next, we're going to install the spark igniter electrode into the fitting on the bottom of the burner. You're going to put it in and slide it all the way in until you feel it bottom out. And then you're going to pull it back approximately a quarter inch or 6 millimeters and hand tighten the fitting. Then we'll connect the terminal lug to the high voltage cable to the end of the spark igniter rod. Lastly, we're going to remove the tie wraps that clamp the ends of the heat pipe to the support ring. Failure to do this could cause the heat pipes to crack when they expand. Now that we have everything installed, we're ready to start the TEG. Check that the fuel pressure is still close to where it was set at the factory. This pressure is marked on the inside of the door of the cabinet. The fuel pressure supplied may need to be adjusted for altitude. Figure 7 in the manual shows the correction for variation from the factory altitude of 750 meters or 2,460 feet. Be sure to use only the type of fuel indicated on the data plate. The maximum inlet fuel pressure must never exceed 172 kPa or 25 psi. Open the fuel valve on the side of the TEG and watch the gauge to see what pressure is coming in. You may notice a higher than rated fuel pressure when you first open the fuel line, but that should drop as you run the system. Before starting the TEG, now would be a good time to check all of your fuel fittings, familiarize yourself with the basic wiring diagram, as well as make sure that the customer load breaker is in the off position. Next, we'll check the operation of the ignition system by shorting the terminals of the pressure switch. I'm going to take this jumper and we're going to put a clip on either side. And at this point, you should hear the ignition sequence start to tick. It should be loud and strong. Then you want to connect your digital multimeter to terminals 6 and 4 on TB1. This will measure your power unit voltage. Next, we'll check that the burner run valve is in the closed position. We can open the external fuel line to allow fuel into the system. Once done, we can press the button on the automatic shutoff valve and allow the flow of fuel into the spark igniter. Once combustion is heard, you want to open the burner run valve. Thank you.
Global Power Technologies. Power where you need it.